Here's another way of thinking about this trade-off. We want to balance the errors that our regression gives us with the number of features that are required to get those errors. We're going to try to maximize the quality of the model that we're making. I haven't totally defined this yet, but let me fill out this graph and you'll get a sense for what I mean by this. Let's suppose I have only one feature in my model. Then I would say that the likelihood is pretty high that I'm underfitting my data, that I have something that's very high bias. So I'd say the quality of the model might be all right, but not as good as it could be. Now let's suppose that I allow a little bit more complexity into my model. I allow it to use three features, and I happen to pick three features that are good at describing the patterns in the data. Then my error is going to go down because my model is now fitting my data in a more precise way. But it's not too complex yet. I'm only using three features, and I've checked each one of them. So the quality of my model has now gone up. So then I say, well, that's pretty sweet. I can improve my model just by adding more features into it. So let me try to add in a whole bunch of features. I'm going to jump up to 15. And I'm hoping that that'll put the quality of my model, say, somewhere up here at the maximal value that it can have. What I'll actually find, though, is that I'm starting to become susceptible to this overfitting, high variance type regime. So maybe the quality of my model has actually become a little bit lower than the quality that it was at three features, because now I'm starting to overfit, where before I was underfitting with one, I'm now overfitting with 15. And if I were to go all the way out to 20, then I might even be doing worse than if I had only one input feature. And so you could imagine that if I sort of filled out this graph for all of the possible number of features that I could get, there would be some best point where the quality of my model is going to be maximized. So a reasonable thing to think, and what we'll talk about for the next few videos, is how we can mathematically define what this arc might be so that we can find this maximum point of it. And this is a process that's called regularization. It's an automatic form of feature selection that some algorithms can do completely on their own, that they can trade off between the precision, the goodness of fit, the very low errors, and the complexity of fitting on lots and lots of different features. So let me show you an example of how regularization works in regressions.